I will. Let us continue now. Now that we've understand Haman's father, symbolically Gaddafi's father, the father of that sort of nature, the Amalek nature. We're now going to touch on Haman because the video that we put up on our YouTube channel, Ethiopian World Net, O-Net, Ethiopian World Net on the YouTubes, it's called Sabbath Zakor. Sabbath Zakor, and we liken, and it was dealing with the Purim. Purim actually means lots, like itta, but in a sense, lots in the modern time would be like dice. In a sense, when it says Purim can be interpreted as dice, so it's rolling the dice, so to speak. And to understand the context with our Black Queen Esther, you have to just go and do some study. We're just giving some of the root information here, the basic information. You can look up some of these things and study for yourself and really come to your own decision about it. Just some of the basics. And what we've seen in breaking down Amalek metaphysically, simply understood as lust, but how that metastasizes. You understand? Metastasizes. In a sense, what Gaddafi represented was not no pan-African liberation like some lost niggas think, some pseudo-pan-African Negroes think. And it really hurts us, you know, to recognize that they don't even recognize this. I mean, what, did Gaddafi pay them off or something? Can't they see? But, you know, the Bible says that some go astray as soon as they are born speaking lies. So, you know, we say arrest. You know, we rest our case on that. But let's move on to our next case. Our next case is Haman. Let's look at Haman. Who is Haman? Who was Haman in this story? Because that's who we liken Gaddafi to. And Haman was a son of Amalek. And Amalek was a son of Esau. Now, from an Egypt perspective, the ancient Egypt, if you want to understand this in the Mishteel or the Mysteries, this will be a pep. All right, we'll get that in just one moment. So, first of all, Haman was the son of Hammedatha. Sound like a Muslim name, like Hamid, right? Hammedatha, the Agagite. The word Agagite, just to break this down for you, when we go Agagite, Agag, right? Agag in the Hebrew equals a pep. And a pep equals Apophis, right? Apophis, which is like an old-time dragon or serpent. It represents a certain, you could say, certain satanic nature, you know, a certain satanic nature, that old serpent, like in Revelation, that old serpent. But in the history of this, this is a pepa was the last of the Hyksos king. This is why when we say that Gaddafi was a Hyksos, right? The Hyksos, or the Hyksos, right? The Hyksos. The Hyksos reign has started with an apepa, and guess what? It ended with an apepa. In other words, an apep. There was a pep who started that when the Hyksos had took over from the native rulers. This is similar to what Gaddafi represents. He took over from King Idris. And King Idris was against that Mussolini fascist European colonization, and they kicked that force out with the help of His Majesty and the other patriotic leaders of the New Africa during the time of Ketamari Haile Selassie. So when Gaddafi came in, he kicked out the one who kicked out the enemies, the evildoers, and started to work with them. So those who think this guy is some pan-Africanist, so forth and so on, you can see he likes a good show. You understand? And he didn't make any sense. He wasn't making no cut. My people love me. Really? Okay, that's how you show love? Nigga, we don't want none of that. We don't want none of that. So it began from the pep, the Hyksos in Egypt. Some say the 100, some say it was more than 100 years. There's still a dispute among Egyptologists how long the Hyksos or the Hyksos. The Hyksos